The X4 comes with standard drive shafts, which are 58 millimeters long in the front. It's a ECS drive shaft, which you may be familiar with from the previous platforms. So it's a double joint drive shaft, which gives the least amount of friction in the front transmission. And on the rear, we have a traditional CVD 54 millimeter drive shaft, which is in aluminium, so it's lightweight. And these drive shafts are basically chosen for a good neutral basic setting of the car, which gives you good handling for most conditions. But we also offer optional drive shafts. We offer the 59 millimeter length front drive shafts, which will give you a smoother car with a bit more cornering speed for large tracks, such as large asphalt tracks or high grip conditions where you need to take away initial steering from the car. And we also offer a shorter rear drive shaft, so a 52 millimeter rear drive shaft, which will improve rotation and off-power steering, but it will reduce the overall grip from the car. So those options are nice to have, but most of the time we prefer to use the standard supply drive shafts. But something that we do use as team drivers are the ball bearing ECS drive shafts, which look like this. So instead of having the plastic drive shaft cap, which is standard, it has small ball bearings which go into the diff out drive. And this has a big benefit for the handling because it reduces the friction between the drive shaft and the out drive. So when the suspension is compressed and when you're in a corner, it puts less load on the drivetrain, and the car will be freer and it will have more grip on that end of the car. So for example, if you run them all around, it will give you more cornering speed and a more efficient drivetrain. If you run them only at the front of the car, it will give you a smoother direction change and just a bit freer front end, a bit more cornering speed, which is especially useful in higher grip conditions. And on the rear, when you put the ball bearing drive shafts on the rear of the car, it will free up the rear, it will give you more steering, more cornering speed, and usually faster lap times for most conditions. So that's why the team prefers to use the ball bearing drive shafts, both for the front ECS shafts and also for the rear CVD shafts. Keep in mind that you'll need to buy the optional diff and solid axle out drives, which are specifically made for the BB drive shafts. So those are really nice options, which I really recommend. But now we're gonna build the kit standard drive shaft, which I have in front of me. So we're gonna start here. I'm gonna put a piece of paper here so I don't make a mess. And we're gonna start with the rear CVD drive shaft. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna install this plastic drive shaft cap onto the drive shaft. So usually what I do is I push this cap onto the drive shaft like that, and I push it against the flat surface to get it installed on the drive shaft. These drive shaft caps are also offered in an orange plastic material, which is basically a graphite material, which is stronger, so they will last longer than the black standard plastic out drives. I'm just going to repeat this process here. Okay, so let's build this drive shaft here. I'm going to show you how to build both one rear and one front drive shaft in this tech tip. So what I do first is I take the large coupling, which is for the rear drive shaft. The smaller couplings are for the front ECS drive shafts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some medium strength tread lock. I'm going to apply this to the small set screw which goes into the coupling. It's very important to use tread lock on this screw because it can come loose from all the vibration. So it's very important to use tread lock there. And then it's important to lubricate this part with Hoodie graphite grease. Looks like this. Actually comes in a kit as well, the graphite grease. And I'm gonna apply a bit of grease here to the coupling, a generous amount, so that it stays lubricated for a fairly long amount of time. And then I take these out drives, put it onto the drive shaft, and we're gonna put the little pins in there. And we tighten this set screw. Make sure it's nice and tight so it doesn't come loose during running. Spin drive shaft done. Gonna take the next one. Sorry, we're gonna do the front drive shaft first, because I want to show you the ECS drive shaft build as well, because it's a little different than the rear. Okay, so repeat the procedure here. We put the drive shaft cap inside. And then we have, instead of one, we have two couplings for the front ECS drive shaft. So we have to do this twice here. We have to install set screws in each of the couplings with treadlock. Both of them. You need to make sure that the treadlock doesn't get onto the coupling itself, because then it can make the drive shaft bind up and you'll have a movement that is not free, and the last thing you want is a binding drive shaft. So put the graphite grease onto the couplings here, install this into the drive shaft itself. That's part number one. Second part is the outer part, the drive axle. Put some graphite grease on here as well. So it's the same procedure as the rear, it's just it has to be done on both the drive axle and the drive shaft. And then we take the big cover or the case of the ECS drive shaft, which connects these two parts. And we put the pins in here. There's two pins, obviously. Tighten the set screw. Actually the wrong pin, make sure you get the correct length pins here, because the pins are shorter for the ECS drive shafts compared to the rear CVD drive shafts. Make sure you get the right length of pins. Then we install the second pin here into the front part. And we tighten that down. And that's all done, all built. Make sure it's free moving with very little friction and no binding. And there we have it. We have the two drive shafts ready, both front and rear. And that's the drive shaft build chapter concluded. So let's finish up the build of these four drive shafts to continue on from our drive shaft tech tip. I'm just gonna repeat the same procedure to these other two drive shafts. So the drive shafts are now done and we have concluded this chapter of the build.